Well, hi, kids. Since I'm down here in the robot lab, you know that today's video is something to do with AI. So our topic today is draw things for Apple Silicon. That's for both Mac OS X and iOS devices, tree on the asset stores. And a recent update included ControlNet imports for SDXL. We've been waiting for that for a while. What we just got was the ability to import specifically Diffusers control nets and Stability AI XL ControlLoRAs. And both collections are on Hugging Face, free to download. And the big difference is between these two is under the hood. So both take different approaches to run on lower RAM hardware. No, control nets have been around for Stable Diffusion 1.5, but the file size of XL models is just geometrically larger. And that's on top of the XL base model, which is already too big to run smoothly on lower RAM devices. So Diffusers remove transformer blocks to get the file size down. They call this distilled. And the cloud downloads of these that are offered inside Draw Things are the mid models. They're about 1 gig each. The full Diffusers models are potentially 5 gigs each. And the small models, which are roughly half, 650 megabytes, and they even have a 16-bit model that's down to 320-ish megabytes. So if you are on an iPhone with very limited RAM, there are options. Just to be perverse, I downloaded one of the full-size 5-gig Diffusers models and I installed it manually. And I'll compare it later with the mid and small models just to see. Now I'm also going to import one of Stability AI's ControlLoRAs from Hugging Face. These are the ControlLoRA from Stability AI, and that name is confusing. Is it a ControlNet? Is it a LoRA? Well, it's a control. We load it in the control interface. The reason Stability calls it a ControlLoRA is because it subtracts from the base model like a LoRA does. So it takes less space in RAM when combined with the base model. The ones here are another depth and another Canny, and I'll compare them, I guess. And also Recolor is a model to colorize black and white photography. And Sketch adds color to black and white graphic design. Seems a little counterintuitive, but these two are both in-paint models because they colorize on top of your image in the canvas. And the simple way to go about this is to go to the control drop-down, click on the manager, and then use the import tab, that's the inbox. Any models that are in your downloads folder will show up in the imports drop-down list, so make sure you have the correct one. Now the only tricky part is that you need to assign an image layer for the control to use, and sometimes it's pretty obvious, but as you can see, there are quite a few more layers here than I expected. Another new feature for Draw Things is that we can now extract a depth map from a regular image through the image layer's import interface. We have new options under the depth layer importer that say extract from photos, files, paste, and canvas. Now when you use the extraction feature for the first time, you'll be prompted to download depth anything. And there's nothing to set up, it installs and runs invisibly every time we need to extract a depth map. This model is only about 60 megabytes. It's reasonably high res, 1036 by 1036, and it seems to work fine in other ratios, even higher resolutions. I tested 5 different depth models, and there are some meaningful differences. From Diffusers, the full 5 gigabyte depth model took about 77 seconds to render on my M1 Mac Studio. The small model took 55 seconds to render, and that's quite a difference. And I have a lot of RAM on my Mac, so it wasn't just about file swapping or memory swapping. The smaller models just run faster. Now, both of those also have 16-bit compressed variant that is half the file size and would presumably render even faster, a little faster. I didn't download those, but in theory, they're just as good, if not better. So I may go back and re-download the 16-bit variants instead. The model that is in the cloud download and draw things is the mid 16-bit variant, and it rendered almost as fast as the small model at 57 seconds. Now, the quality of all three seemed close, with the full model being the most sharp and accurate, in that it showed any background details that I failed to paint out. They showed up as lines and buildings in the background. So just giving out some awards as we go, the Diffuser's large model was the most accurate and the least forgiving and also the biggest download. The Diffuser's small model was the fastest to render, and it didn't exactly show the flaws in the depth map as much, meaning it was less accurate. If you want small and fast, this is probably the one. Now, on the stability depth control LoRA, there are two models, essentially a medium and a small, rank 256 and rank 128. Rank 256 was the slowest of all the models, even slower than the Diffuser's large model, which is 5 gigs. R256 rendered in 80 seconds and R128 in 77 seconds. So the smaller model, R128, took as long to render as the Diffuser's full model. Stability wins no prizes for speed. However, the stability models were the most flexible. They did not show the flaws in my depth map. In fact, the image almost always looked perfect. They had more depth. And I also found it better for prompting. I was able to change my shirtless depth map into a guy wearing a suit and tie while keeping his other details. Rank 256 was the best at this by far. In fact, I'd give it the overall best model award, except it's also the slowest. Rank 128 could also put him in clothes and change him through prompts, but it had weird flaws, like sometimes rendering the subject again outside the depth map. And that error doesn't make up for the 3 seconds shaved off the render time. But with both models, the backgrounds were deeper and better at following the prompts than the Diffuser's models. So to recap, Diffuser's small is fastest and lightest. Diffuser's large is the most mechanically accurate. Stability's rank 256 is the best at prompting and also the slowest. Now let's move on to the Canny models. Canny is usually confused with a black on white line art model, but it's not really. It's an edges model, where the edges are the information, so they are white on black. Now that said, Canny does also work with line art, but you might really want to download Stability's sketch model, which I'll show later. If you have an edge map, load it into the custom layer. It's designed to read white on black images. If you have line art, like coloring book outlines, load it in the canvas layer. If there's no image in the custom layer, draw things will point them to look for black and white images in the canvas. Now, I tested essentially the same models just for Canny on their own, and interestingly, the render times were about the same as the depth model, so similar size, similar render times. Now, visually, there's a stark difference in the Diffuser's Canny and the Stability Canny. Diffuser's was very flat, like a relief or like a bump map, and that didn't get better with the different versions. Actually, I think I imported the big one wrong, but whatever. Now, maybe this works better with edge maps, the white on black. I used coloring book LoRA to make some black and white line art, but I would not use this model for my art. Maybe I just don't have the right kind of input. In contrast, Stability's Canny seemed more like what I was expecting. The image is more polished overall. The colors are off, but there is depth, some depth, although it looks better with an actual depth map. So I'm showing it here with the R256 depth model. Again, I would rate them as the Diffuser's Canny have sort of a mechanical precision look, while Stability's is more artistic. My artwork looked better with Stability, but I can think of things like maybe jewelry design, mechanical design, where I would really want the sharper relief quality from Diffuser's. Now, one thing I don't like about Canny is the colors. They're strange. They're flat, like an unlit texture map. And the highlights at the outlines are sometimes over the top, way too much, glowing. So this is Sketch, another stability model. And this is kind of what I always expect Canny to look like. As you can see, the light, the colors, and the skin are really nice when it combines with the depth model. Overall, this is my favorite combination, depth and sketch, with a coloring book image in the canvas to make everything happen. Now, Sketch also seems really good at prompting. It's easy to do day or night and to change the tone and mood while keeping the artwork essentially intact. Now, the last model is called Recolor, and it's basically for colorizing vintage black and white photography. I'm not a fan of this model. I think I'm just not a fan of colorized photography. So it does not remake the image. It's not an image to image. It's an in painting, and it looks it. It looks like hand retouched or hand painted, or maybe just computer repainted black and white photography. That is the end of this video and tutorial. Please give a like if you think that this information is useful to other people and you want YouTube to recommend it for other people to find. And feel free to subscribe if you want. I do have other videos about draw things coming, and not all of my videos are about draw things.